mentioned earlier, all non-essential personnel leave the grid now.
Alright, hello everyone, and welcome to the 2015 Race of Champions by GPVWC. Today is the first round of the group events, and yeah, it's now our turn. Me and Menno Klont are going up against Jason Muscat and Tomeu Cabra in the Audi, which is going to be fun. So Menno's up first against Muscat. So we just get to watch for 2 minutes as they go around. Yeah, I'm just trying to relax for my turn now, because I don't want to let Menno down. They've got to go twice round, twice on the outside and on the inside. The thing is, after like one lap, they're all over the place. You don't know who's in the lead. It's only really now you can kind of get a bit of an understanding. It looks like Menno may be up a... yeah, slightly ahead. Seconds between them. Is it across the line? 2.7. So as long as Menno keeps this lap clean, he may have it. Ooh, did he make a bit of a mistake there? Nice, Menno. Nice. Now it's my turn. My turn to prove what I can do. Missed it. Thanks, Dave. Right. So you don't really get to change much on the cars apart from brake pressure, bias, and steering lock. There's no point changing me now, because well, there's an actual bit of footage on the TV from Race of Champions. Yeah, there's no point changing it now, because when I go into proper race, then it'll just be overwritten. Cabra's getting some last second practice in. So wait for the grid to be set. Hang on, let's just do.
Rear field is enabled.
A little bit. What's the maximum I can do? 30, yeah, I'm gonna put it 35.
Real field is enabled.
No jump in the start. I'm already 2 seconds behind Cabra.
Thank you.
Oh, that was close. Whew. And now it's me against Jason Muscat now. How close was that across the line? Oh no, this is the... Okay. Oh wow. That close. Can't spell, got gloves on. That was the first race. Well, for me anyway. So if I win this... I put my steering lock up to maximum. 38. Right.
Rear field is enabled.
Muscat's leaving it very late. Oh, Muscat had a massive error there. That was I was just slow coming out the final. So we do get to see Menno versus Cabra, or Menno versus Tomeo. That's over. And I progressed through to the quarterfinals, because it goes quarter, semi, then final. I think so, I can't remember. I never know how the way it goes. But yeah. I think tomorrow I'll face whoever is the victor between Sven De Vries and Cameron Brewster versus Lars Brugman and Niels Brugman. So either way, it's not going to be a tough battle tomorrow. We'll watch this one out. Whew.
Attention grid, will all non-essential personnel leave the grid now?
Whilst everything's waiting to kick off, I will say that I did the Race of Champions in 2013 for GBVWC. There wasn't one last year. And I got to the semi-finals? The one before the finals. And then lost it. Just couldn't drive the car. Well, it was a kart. It was absolutely horrible. But, you know, I did well in the first round, which was the Caterham, and then the second round, which was a front-wheel drive, I'd like to say Volkswagen. Ooh, Cabra's caught well up. I guess it's the tight final or penultimate corner that these cars don't like. Yeah, it's close. This is going to be good. Just hit the wall. But yeah, this will be my final R-Factor event. R-Factor 1 event. I'm still doing R-Factor 2. R-Factor 2 is just the way forward. It's a no-brainer. But yeah, so I'm still doing the Virtual Endurance Championship. That'll be every month, but the next one after Sao Paulo is February, so that's quite a bit of a gap. Yeah. It's sad to see R-Factor 1 go since I've been doing it for 3 years, but you know, with R-Factor 2, there's really no competition or no reason to stay on number 1. Nice one, Menno. Nice one.